Hi, my name is Adam Meixler, and this is the show Simmpletech. Today we're going to be talking about Windows 95. Most new computers ship with Windows 95. It's a popular graphic user interface. A graphic user interface is just an easy way of letting the user do what he or she wants. Let's go to Windows 95 now. Here you see that this is the desktop. This is the main screen to Windows 95. When you start it, this will be the first thing you see. On the desktop is My Computer, the Internet, Network Neighborhood, Inbox, and Recycle Bin. There's two other icons here that we'll get to later. This little white thing you see flying around is called the cursor, or the arrow. It's used to give commands to the computer and tell it what to do. First thing I'm going to do is show you different parts of a window. To do that, we have to start a new program. To save time, I'll do it fast and explain to you later. This is a window. This is a program, and all programs are kept in a window. With the window, there's this part up top, which is called the title bar. It gives you the name of the program, and also these three little icons on the right-hand side. These icons are for minimize, maximize, and close. Let's try one of them. We'll try minimize. And it minimizes it down here. If we want to start the program again or open it back up, we just click right there and there it is. The next bar here is the toolbar. All your tools are here. Open, save, find, and other things are up here. The bar below that is your format bar. This bar is used to decide what font or what size you want, and other things such as indent, numbering, and bulleting. The thing below that is a ruler. This tells you what your tabs are set to, how far in you're going, and other things you need to know. This whole white thing here, it's your document window. This document window is where you type in what you want the computer to save. The document window is like a typewriter. It takes commands right from the keyboard. I just type that in, and there it is in the window. There's two other bars here on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. These are called scroll bars. Now suppose that your document doesn't fit in a window, doesn't fit in the same window, like this. We can scroll to see it. Granted, that's not a good example. We can scroll to see it. If there are many, many lines, we would use a scroll bar. Now, there's a couple of basic techniques that you use with the mouse that I'll explain to you. The first is click. Click is just a single click using the left mouse button. It allows you to select stuff, things to do and other types of things. The next type of click is called a double click. If I wanted to open up my computer, I would use a double click. And there it is. Other kinds of clicks are right click. The new feature to Windows 95 is it allows you to right click almost anywhere. Using the right mouse button, I click once and I get this pop-up menu. Other things you can do with the mouse is to drag something. Say I want to drag it to down here. It allows me to. I can also point at something, which I'll be doing a lot to explain to you what things are. Now, in my computer, you see these mini icons. These represent disk drives on your computer. You have the A drive, which is your standard disk drive, external disk drive. This is your C drive, which is your hard drive. And this right here is your CD drive. If I had a CD in the disk drive, then you would be able to see it here. This is if you're connected to a network but no connection is made. This is the printers. The printers are just what you have connected to your computer to allow you to put text output. This is your dial-up networking. Like if you want to get on the internet or connect to an external computer that you'd like to network with, you use dial-up networking. This is control panel. Control panel controls most of the things that your computer does and how it does it. That's it for my computer. Now, back, I told you that I'd show you how to start a program. It's fairly simple. Down here, you see start. You left click or just click once. You bring the cursor up to programs. You see all these programs here that's installed on your computer. Just click once on any of these programs and they'll start, such as Microsoft Word. Now that we're in Microsoft Word, we can make it a window, maximize it, minimize it, open it up again, or close it. Now, this is the recycle bin on the desktop. The recycle bin is kind of a safety net. All the things that you delete off your hard drive go here first. Just in case a week later, a month later, or whenever you've decided that you need a file that you've deleted, this is where you come to get it. The recycle bin is, like I said, a safety net for deleted files. Now, the only thing is that there's an option which allows you, right here, if we had something in here, it would say empty recycle bin. If you decide to empty recycle bin, all the data that you've put into it by deleting will be completely wiped off your hard drive. You'll not be able to ever get that data back. And also you see in recycle bin, it's got these same three little icons up in the corner. All Windows 95 programs have those three little icons. Now suppose that you have this recycle bin, but you decide, this window, it's too large. I need to make it smaller. Down here, you see these three lines, diagonal lines. You put your cursor over it, and when it turns to that mouse cursor with the two arrowheads, then you click and hold and drag it to the size you want. That gray outline is the size it's going to become. You let go, and it becomes that size. Suppose that you don't want the window there. You want it somewhere over here where you can see it easier. You click on the title bar, hold it, and drag the window over to here. Once you do that, you let go, and it'll stay there for you. Well, that's enough with the recycle bin right now. Let's close it. Just so you know, if you'd like to shut down your computer, there's an easy way of doing that. You go start, shut down. I'll do that again in case you didn't see it. You go start, and you click shut down. Now you have options that come up here. You say, yeah, I do want to shut down my computer. So you click there, and you hit yes. Now this screen comes up, saying it's now safe to turn off your computer. Do not turn your computer off until this screen comes up, or else you'll run the risk of losing data. Now, since we want to restart it, we'll just hit Alt, Control, Delete. And now the program, Windows 95, will begin to start again. It takes a while, so you'll just have to wait with us. So I've showed you how to minimize an application, start an application, maximize an application, exit an application, and how to use my computer and the recycle bin. You also know how to delete things permanently from your disk. Although we haven't showed how to delete files, we'll get there. Now, this should be the standard screen that you see when Windows 95 is starting out. Now, this opens. The first few screens you see when Windows 95 starts up will vary depending according to the computer. This computer is configured to have these programs run when the computer is started. So now we're back into Windows 95 and we can do whatever we want. Now, we're going to decide to run Microsoft Word again. Here's Microsoft Word. Now, suppose we're typing something. Suppose we type that, but suppose we want this to repeat many times over. We don't want to have to type it over and over and over again. So there's a simple way of doing it. You select the text. You can select text by either putting your cursor over the text and dragging over the text you wish to select, or you see that blinking line in the middle of the word. You can hold shift and use the arrows to select the text. Or the third way, which is to move your arrow over to the left-hand margin until you see that arrow pointing in the opposite direction. You click, and it selects the whole line. Now that's what we want it to do. Now, there's a function in most Windows applications which allows you to repeat the same text over and over and over again. And the way you do that is you go up to this menu. You click the command Edit. You click the command Edit, then you drag down until you see Copy. You let go on Copy. And now the computer puts it in a place where it can retrieve it again and again. Now if we want a new line, we click at the end of this line, hit Enter, and then come up to Edit and go Paste. And there it is again. Now we can do this as many times as we'd like. Now, when you go up to Edit, next to Paste, you see the letters Control plus V. That means that if you're in this document and you press Control V, the same thing will happen. It will keep coming up. There's also a third way to do it. Windows 95 has a built-in feature that if you right-click, a menu will come up. One of the options there is Paste. It allows you to paste it over and over and over. Now, in Windows 95, there's multiple ways of doing everything. If you don't do it one way, you can do it the other way, and it'll still come out perfectly fine. Now another feature you can use in Windows 95 is the Find, which is Control F, if you like. You want to say, well, I want to find hello. We come over here, go Find Next. It finds each hello. Find Next, and it'll find all the hellos in the document. Now, suppose we don't want to do this anymore. We can just simply hit Cancel, and it gets us back to the document itself. Now, suppose we're done with this document, but we don't want to lose the data we put in this document, the hello and welcome. So the way to do this is to save your document. You save your document to a disk, either a floppy disk you put into your computer or your hard disk, which stays in your computer. You can go File, Save. Now, we'll just say, we'll call it Simmpletech. And now we'll go Save. And now the data is stored on the hard drive and it will not be wiped off unless we wish it to. There's also many ways of doing that. See, next to save, there's a Control S. If we're in the document and we want to save, we hit Control S and it saves it. Now, with save, that box that came up the first time asking me to name it will only come up the first time. That asks for an initial name you want to give it. That name, as long as you use the save command, will stay the same. If you hit save, it'll keep saving the document as the same name. Suppose we want to rename the document. We go up to File and Save As. And now we'll give it a new name. And we go save. Now it saves the document as a new file with a different name. Now, save is good because if you don't want to take time out from typing, you can just hit Control S and it'll save all your typing up to there. You should save about every 15 minutes or whenever you feel the need to. If you feel that your computer will crash soon, or that computer unfriendly situations are starting, you should save. Now, up here, this is the toolbar. Toolbars are different in different applications. But in Windows 95, they try to simplify things. So as you move over an icon, and if you stay there, it will give you the name of that icon and what it does. Now, suppose you want to save the document without hitting Control S or without going File Save. We can use this icon right here on the toolbar. We click it and it saves the document. It's all done. Suppose we want to find something without going Control F or without going to Edit Find. There's this icon right here. Actually, that was a print preview icon. My producer is laughing because I was supposed to know this. Unfortunately, that's a print preview icon, and the Find button is not on this toolbar. Suppose we want to go paste. There's an easy way of doing that. There's this icon right here, and it pastes it. So, as you see, in Windows 95, there's many, many ways of doing stuff. Whether you want to do it by a toolbar, by a shortcut key, or by the menus, it doesn't matter. All the things will have the same impact on your work. Now suppose that we want to edit this document. Suppose that we've made a mistake, like right here. We click, and the blinking line comes up right there next to it. We hit backspace, and it's all gone. And it is all gone. Suppose we want to take one whole line out. We come over here, get this reverse arrow, get the whole line selected, and hit delete. And now that line is gone. Well, that's enough for now. We'll be right back. Hi, and welcome back to Simmpletech. Well, to close out the show, I'll just show you something that you can use whenever you get bored of what the desktop looks like. Now, on this desktop, you see the icons are all set to the left, and it's got this plain green background. Well, suppose you don't like this green background or you're getting bored of it. There's an easy way to change it. You right-click anywhere on the green background, then drag down until you see properties highlighted. Left click once. This screen comes up. You have multiple options of different ways you can configure your desktop. On the left hand side, these are patterns that will go on your monitor. You can have checkerboard, weave, and different assorted ones. On the right, these are different wallpapers. A wallpaper is a picture which we place on your desktop. Suppose we choose this one. We'll have that set as our desktop. Suppose we choose this one. We'll have a plain purple background. This one, we'll get that. And so on. And you can go through these having fun seeing which ones you like. Suppose we like this one. We hit apply. And there it is on the background. That may be hard for you users at home to see on a TV, but all you have to do is hit apply and it changes. I'll keep it at this so it's easier to see on a TV. When you're done, you just hit OK. Another thing is that if these icons don't really make any sense to you, you can rename them. Right-click once, drag down to rename. A cursor comes up with the text highlighted all in blue with white sides. Now, you can type whatever you want this to be to make it easier to explain to you what this is. Now, when you click off of it, that's what you'll see. Now, the names that you see can be up to 255 characters long. So you can have fun coming up with nice long names to mark things by. Well, that's enough for this show. Please come back next week.